Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Asian American Arts Alliance's May Town Hall. My name is Nico Gassoni, Program Director here. We're so excited to see you all, new faces, returning faces. This is, of course, a special one for us, and we hope for you, because it's APA Heritage Month. We saw some of you on Sunday at the at our booth at Union Square. Happy to see you today. For those of you who don't know yet, we have also on Thursday Brainstorm, our second event in our series of mindy workshops. I'll tell you a little bit more about them later on. So it's a full week for us. In addition to this, you may have seen messages yesterday, and you may already have set up profiles, but we launched our brand new online platform for you to set up your own profiles, to add your own events, add your portfolios of work. We'll go into that a little bit later. So it's an information-packed week for us, and I'm sure for you, a lot of you have events coming up this month, and we're really happy to be here, to be able to host you. Thanks also to Ari for having us here today. The setup for Town Hall is very simple. For those of you who are new, people who are on the pitch list, I will call, not necessarily in order, it depends on who's here, and you get 2 minutes to pitch, and I actually time it on my iPhone. At 120 seconds, I have this bell that I ring, and that is the signal that it's time for you to stop. We do this in order to be respectful of everybody else's time, and also we are convinced that if you can deliver your pitch in less than 2 minutes, it's probably better than if you were going to go on for longer, because people will tune you out. So do this as a matter of respect for everybody else, and our target is always to go through pitches within an hour. I think we have about 20 plus. If you're not on the list of pitches, but you do want to say something at the end, we reserve time for what we call micro pitches, and those are 30 seconds. And so just know that everybody can speak and can say something. Come up at the end when we invite you for micro pitches. So I think we'll start. We started a little bit late. Sorry about that. We had some technical issues. I'd like it if we could just very quickly go around and please tell us your names and if you work with an organization, which organization, and then after that we'll get going. Mari, could you join?
And make sure you speak loud enough so everyone.
Yes, we don't have a handheld today, so if you can speak up.
Stand,
yes.
Hi, my name is Mari, and I'm a graphic media designer, and I actually just moved here from Los Angeles in the end of January because he stole me away from California to get married.
I'm Mari's husband. I play Japanese flutes, Japanese drums, and I teach the taiko and perform. And I think we'll be hearing more, a little bit more about me later. So.
Hi, my name is Luca. Friend of Lauder. And I guess I play music. Sing and play ukulele. So that's it.
Hi, good morning. My name is Liz Young, and I am a trainer and consultant, and my passion is passing on the wisdom and experience and perspective that I've gained over 23 years of working with corporations around the world to Asian American professionals and artists so that you can present your best foot forward wherever you are and get what you really want.
Hi, my name is Keishi, and I was brought up in New Zealand and Australia. New York is my home now for a long time. I'm happy to be here.
Hi, my name is Suzanne Spear, and I am working with Keishi on her two dance companies, Pure and Belly Queen. I'm a writer, and so I'm working on funding, and they've been touring a lot. You'll hear that later in the micro pitches, so I'm helping grant writing with that.
Hi, my name is Kyoko, New Caledonian, and I brought today my vocalist. Her name is Nell. She's going to sing later.
Hi, my name is Louise Brooks, and I'm with the Ruben Museum of Art. My name is Yasuo Tanaka, and I'm flute maker and bookbinder, and I'm teaching.
My name is Omar Shakino, and I'm a visual artist at University College.
Billy Fox, I'm the director of the Kitsune Ensemble, a Japanese and American improvising chamber ensemble, and I'll be pitching that.
I'm Debbie Branch, and I'm an artist. I also have a magazine blog, which is moviearreview.wordpress.com.
I'm Janice Wan, interim director for the Alliance. Welcome, and I'm here to soak up the energy today. Thanks.
My name is Richard. I'm a filmmaker and intern here at the Alliance.
Hi, my name is Vivas Chaudhuri, and I try to paint. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Ashok Sinha. I'm an editorial and documentary photographer in New York.
Hello, good morning. My name is Howen Wong. I work at LMCC, Northern Manhattan Cultural Council. I'm a program manager of Rents and Services. I used to work at the Alliance, and I was here for the first town hall, so it's really good to see you all.
My name is Chen Qiyang. I'm a sexual artist.
Hello, I'm Eileen Chan. I'm a visual artist right now in painting, book arts, and printmaking. I'm soon to be going to graduate school in art therapy in Illinois.
Hi, good morning. I'm Judai Ree Alloway, and I'm a visual artist, a painter, and a writer, with a soon coming up book of my life story, an excerpt of it. And in my spare time, I also run a women's leadership development program for National Association of Asian American Professionals. And in my spare time, I'm also a political activist. Thank you for all being here.
Hi, good morning. I'm Veronique, and I'm an organization called Ammonium, and I'm promoting Indian classical music here.
Hi, I'm Faye Lim. I'm a freelance dance artist and teacher.
Hello, my name's Asuka, and I'm actually an undergrad student visiting here from Vancouver. Well, I've done Japanese traditional dance, and I'm learning Aikido right now. Nice meeting you.
Hi, I'm Elaine Panda, and I'm the artistic director of a dance company, and I am also a cross-cultural consultant / dance educator in the Brooklyn public schools.
Hi, I'm Caroline Sun. I'm a painter, and my work is by a secret line of that.
Hi, my name is Yun Cho. I'm a visual artist who works with video photography, and I live and work in Florence.
Oh, I'm Michael Mao. I'm a choreographer.
My name is Samuel Bushimaeus, and I'm an Arabic violinist and composer, and I direct an Arabic music and dance ensemble called Zikrayat.
Hi, my name is TJ. I'm a physical and body balance therapist and a Reiki master from Tokyo.
Hi, I'm Mana. I'm a dancer and choreographer originally from Japan, and also I'm a Reiki yoga instructor. And I'll be doing a pitch later. Thank you.
Oh. Hi, I'm Margot Maslow. I'm a program assistant at the Alliance. And by the way, Asuka is my cousin.
Jessica from Knifer is here too, I guess. And Krista from Toronto.
Performing
Arts
Center, exactly.
So I think we'll get started now. I think we covered everybody. Yes, raise your hand if you're not. We have a new person. Please just tell us your name.
Hi.
So without further ado, please welcome our good friend to introduce this very special APA town hall, our good friend Kaoru Watanabe.
Nico has asked me to perform a few times to open up these town halls, but today I thought I'd try something different. He said specifically not to play the flute, and so I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to teach you guys some rhythms, and we'll see how quickly we can pick them.
And these are kind of traditional rhythms used in kabuki or these Japanese traditional musics. And there's going to be two parts. So, musicians or people who are somewhat musically inclined, if you could raise your hand. And this is purely if you, you know. Okay, you guys are the B team, okay? Everyone else, repeat, clap after me, okay? So the first phrase is... Oh, listen first. I see that one already. Very good. Okay, good. So, continuing along, it's... Okay, so it's... Okay, so the A part is tan ten ton ton ten ten ton ton ten ton ten ton ten ton ten ton. Okay, the B part will go ten 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 ten. Violence. Can we do this? A little bit slower. 1 2 3 4.
Beautiful.
Anyone else want to try?
No.
Okay. just a little bit. Just a little bit more. We're just gonna do that first phrase. Ten, ten, ton, ton, ten, ten, ton, ton, ten, ton, ten, ton, ten, ton, ten, ton. Same thing over again. And just repeat that 3 times, okay? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Followed by Kyoko and Nami. Hi, Billy Fox, director of the Kitsune Ensemble, and very briefly, it's a half Japanese, half American improvising chamber ensemble, and we're particularly interested in multidisciplinary collaboration, so I'm not pitching anything in particular other than anyone interested in this sort of stuff, I'd love to talk to you, and now we're going to show a little bit of video. Thank you.
How many of you feel like you could really work on your presentation skills? Okay. How many of you wish you could kind of tell people what you do and what you're passionate about in 30 seconds? How many of you would like to be able to ask for what you're really worth and what your art is worth? Okay. Come June 2nd at Mocha, June 2nd from 2 to 5 in the afternoon. I'm presenting a full skills-based program. We're not going to talk about how you do these things. We're going to be talking and practicing how you actually do it, what you need to know, and then how you do it. That's what we're going to be doing. So if you are interested, I have passed them out on the chair, and I also have more here, and I'll put some on the table. Thank you for your attention. I hope I see many of you there, because your work is so precious, and it's a shame that people don't see the brilliance that we each have within us. Thank you.
Good morning, my name is Kyoko. I'm going to introduce my vocalist from Japan. She's going to run for Madonna Gospel Fest as a finalist. This is first time as a Japanese. So I hope you enjoy the gospel. My information on the agenda, and she's going to stay a couple years in New York. So if you have any opportunity to let her sing, please let me know. Any event, any community things, or any church things, school or meeting, anything. Thank you.
I'd like to invite Louise Brooks, followed by Howen Wong, followed by Fei Lin.
And we are a museum of Himalayan art in Chelsea. And I'll let you go to the website to see some of the exhibitions we have going on, because I want to tell you about a few upcoming programs. But just as an example, a recent exhibition that just opened is called Remember That You Will Die, Death Across Cultures. And it looks at memento mori, which are images, symbols, reminders of our mortality found in different forms in both Tibetan Buddhism and Western Christianity. So. The bridge actually in the exhibition that brings those two cultures together for the exhibition is a video piece by contemporary artist Bill Viola. So if you want to see how that all works, I recommend you go check it out. I've got some flyers all throughout May. We're screening a film called Journey from Zanskar, and there are screenings throughout May. It's actually by the director who made Hoop Dreams, if you remember that documentary that came out a few years ago. It's a really compelling film, so please check that out. If you're interested in organizing a group to come, I can offer you a special student discount, so it'd be $7 per person as opposed to $12, so definitely contact me if you'd like to come with a group, and I'll set that up for you. Two new programs, things we've never done before, are coming up. One is our first ever classical music series. It's a Sunday night series, and it's kicking off this Sunday on May 9th with the Shanghai Quartet. I brought flyers, I gave them out to a lot of people, but they're also on the table there, so if you didn't get one, please check it out. It's going to be very exciting. They're also offering a student discount to this May 9th performance, and it's pretty significant. So if you're interested, please contact the box office or me about that. And then lastly, in June, for the first time ever, to celebrate Pride Month, we're going to be running a Wednesday night series of programs called Out in the Himalayas, and each program will examine some issue of lesbian, gay, or transgender issues in the Himalayas. And so those are very unique, and I don't have printed brochures, but you should definitely check out the website for that. And contact me if you'd like to gather before one of those.
Again, good morning. No, by show of hands, by show of hands, how many of you are teaching artists or works in a school context? Great. How many of you know teaching artists or know artists that work in school? That's great. Okay, so my name is Howen Wong. I'm from the Lower Manhattan Cultural Council, from the Grants and Services Department. I'm here to announce Creative Curricula and Arts and Education Partnership Grant between a arts nonprofit or individual teaching artist partnership with the Manhattan School. So if yourself or anybody knows about might be eligible, you are welcome to take a flyer, which is right there, sitting on the desk. And basically what this grant is it provides up to $5,000 of matching grants for a partnership between, like I said, a Manhattan school and a teaching artist or a cultural organization. The teaching artist or cultural organization doesn't have to be Manhattan-based, but the school has to be a Manhattan school. Okay, and the deadline for the grant is June 22nd, and then we do require first-time applicants to come to one of our information sessions. You can find the information about the info sessions on our website. I'm just going to go over it really quickly. There are three in May. First one is May 13th at the Manhattan Neighborhood Network, May 19th at Harlem Arts Alliance, and May 24th at LMCC. You can find all this information. You need to RSVP online at lmcc.net. And that's about it. And also I want to tell you an opportunity that we provide is a workshop. It's a free workshop that we provide to artists to create your own free website. So Steve Lambert, who is a self-taught media artist, is gonna keep leading that panel. You can, again, log on to lmcc.net and RSVP or email me if you can't find that information online. Some more information here, but I run out of time, so you can look over there, and that's my pitch.
Hi, my name is Fei Lim. I'm here to talk about this new Chinatown dance project that I'm trying to put together with some friends. I work mostly improvisationally in dance with the Dana Salisbury Company with the Noceums, and we have been creating improvisational scores, and I wish to, with my friends who work in a more traditional realm of dance, we're coming together and we'd like to work with families in the Chinatown area, but we're also open to young children and their parents from anywhere in New York City. We want to share with them the creative process, if that's beneficial to them. That process of working collaboratively, figuring out how to partner your mom or in a physical way, and also to think about how their movement they have authority over their movement, and as a family, like they can create a dance, and we're there to facilitate them creating a dance for their family. So we want to try to get that going. If you have kids, if you have families that you, your neighbors who may be interested in this, I'll be here till the end of the town hall, so feel free to come up and talk. Thank you.
Teiji Nagashima, please, followed by Sunny Abu Shumais, followed by Yun Cho.
Hi,
name is TJ. I'm from Tokyo. I'm a professional body balance therapist. And I'm going to show you the slide. My therapy is to regain the balance of body. A very good people has a misalignment body, so for the health, kind of misalignment body, we have with a natural habit or a movement. Then the body, as we say, scream and so air, help. It is for example, my patients, that his spine is not in center, but after treatment, he regained balance of body. This is both of his also. He was 10 years old, rebalanced. Nothing to do with age, from baby to people who need a rehabilitation. So, very easy, visual change to body. It's awesome. He's a Down syndrome. He's a Down syndrome. He originally has a problem with musculoskeletal system, but can change if I control the muscle. Muscle pulls the bone. Because I have many seminars in the north of Japan, but also in Manhattan. And first we check the balance of the arms, both arms. Look, they're very different between the right and left. So after this seminar and this meeting, please check by yourself. We need to find out. Yes, from July I'm have a special seminar, not only the ART, anti-aging rebound therapy, but also Reiki special seminar from July. Please sign up my therapy. And I do a private session in Manhattan as well. So I have to leave it in New York next week temporarily, but I come back to have here in July. So I will see you again soon. Thank you very much.
Hi everybody, I'm Sam Abushimayez, and as I mentioned, I direct an Arabic music and dance group called Zikrayat. We specialize in music, especially music and dance from Egypt, and we do a sort of a variety show format where we include vocal music, classical music, and dance performances. Our specialty is repertory from Egyptian movie musicals of the 1950s especially, but also from the 40s to the 60s. And we also do a multimedia show to highlight that. This is a piece I'm going to play you just about a minute of that includes vocals, dance, and film. And we're going to be doing a multimedia show this Friday. I'll tell you about it just after the clip. Friday at 8 p.m. It's going to be a mix of multimedia and variety, so we'll have some of the multimedia pieces with the Egyptian film clips, as well as some just dance pieces, some vocal pieces. We also just released a new CD this Saturday, Cinematic, so that will be for sale at the show. So thank you very much. The website listed for me, a better website to go to is zikrayatmusic.com, Z-I-K-R-A-Y-A-T. music.com, and CDs are for sale there, and information about the performance.
Hi, Hi, my name is Yoon Cho. I'm a visual artist based in Long Island City. And Long Island City Alliance is having a Long Island City Open Studios on Saturday, May 22nd, and Sunday, May 23rd, noon to 6 p.m. But our, from 1 to 6 p.m. actually, but this is Paint Can Studios, where I work. And we are going to open the studio from noon to 6 p.m. There will be total over 110 artists who live and work in Long Island City participating in this event. So please come and join us. My studio is, again, located in Pinkin Studios number 318. Right there. So please come and say hello. I left, I'm leaving the flyers out there. So please take those on the way out. And then if you would like to know the directions how to get there, it's really close, just one stop from Manhattan. So there's the map and then the subway directions right there. There will be multiple buildings, not just our building, who is participating in it. So there will be more flyers. Once you get there, you can get more information about other buildings as well. Thank you. See you there.
Since I have the bill, I can make a very long pitch now. But I'm not. I promise to stay within Liz's limits of making it consistent and concise. I wanted to announce, for those of you who have not seen it yet, a brand new online platform. This has been in the works for several months now. A lot of you who have come to our website before have been able to add events. And as paying members of the Alliance, you've had your profile, but those have been static. We've heard from a lot of you. And we've also seen shifts in the way people are using media, that there was a need for more interactivity. So this platform now allows you to set up a profile, add your portfolios, add your music, add your videos, add your events, contribute to discussions in the forum, find opportunities in the forum. Everything is linked. So if someone comes and sees your profile, they will see your events. If they come to your event, they will see more about your profile and will see your videos. So we encourage you to set up a profile. It's free now to set up a profile to become a member. For those of you who are current paying members, and for those of you who want to continue supporting the Alliance and want to increase your visibility on this platform, you can upgrade to this new program that we have called Alliance Plus. With Alliance Plus, once you've signed up and you've paid your membership fee, it's still very reasonable, only $40 for an entire year for an artist and $60 for an organization. We feature you. We feature you on the homepage like this, Thai Artists Alliance. We feature your images. Marco, if you could just scroll up on the scrolling banner when you add them. We feature you on the e-blasts that go out on our Facebook and on our Twitter pages. So you're welcome to set up a profile. Know that for extra visibility, you can upgrade to Alliance Plus. We just launched, we did a soft launch last month. A lot of you have set up profiles. I think we're at 100 and, there's a shock, I promise we're there. I think we're at 125 members already. Just we did an announcement yesterday. Some of you will have seen it. We're working very hard on this, we're very excited. We really want your feedback and want to know if this is useful to you. If you don't have a website and you've been scared about setting up a URL and going through the motions, this is a way to do it. You can point people to your page. If you do have a website, this is an easy way to point people back to your website and vice versa. So we know that we're one of the many communities that you inhabit, and just like Town Hall, we want to create a space, Town Hall being maybe offline, we want to create a space online where you can meet, where you can discuss issues that relate to being Asian and Asian American and an artist in New York City, as well as find resources. On this platform, you can now email each other directly. So if you found another artist that you want to collaborate with, you don't have to come to us to ask us for their contact information. You can email them there. You can add them as a friend and continue your conversation. So that is our new online platform. The URL is aaartsalliance.org, which it was before, so we've now basically revamped it and using our own URL. We encourage you to put a profile image if you set up a profile and haven't done so yet, put up a profile image. As you probably know, we get a lot of visitors to this website, so the fuller your profile, the more chance people will come and visit your profile. And for Alliance Plus, the process is that if you add a certain number of photos, we will add a certain number of those on the home page. So if you add between 1 and 9 images, we will add 1 on the home page, between 10 and 19, 2, etc. So we encourage you to add a lot of images and add them often so that they are constantly showing up on our homepage scroller, and when you click on that image, it takes you to a bigger version and then to information about the artist. I'd like to take a couple of questions if you have, and then maybe afterwards we can just talk about this more later on. Simi.
I'm sorry, did you say it was members only for the profile, or anyone can add a profile?
Anybody can set up a profile. We have a range of questions.
So there's no way to distinguish who's a member and who's not?
Well, for everybody now becomes a member, as long as you have a profile. If you're a paying member, you're now an Alliance Plus member.
Okay,
so if you go, for example, America, if you go to community, the top, you'll have an Alliance Plus members at the top here, and that takes you to all of the members that we have who pay the fee for currently 73 of the 150 actually who are current paying members, and these members will get on our e-blasts, will get on the homepage, will get the images on the homepage, the videos featured.
If you're a paying member of the Alliance and not an Alliance Plus member, there's no way.
This is it. This is now Alliance Plus. If you're a paying member of the Alliance, you're now Alliance Plus. So yes, Aline.
I guess it goes along with that question. I'm a member of the Alliance and was trying to, log on to the Alliance Plus, and it says to pay. And I was like,
You said what, sorry, Aline?
Well, basically, on the website, I'm a member already, a paying member of the Alliance, and
signed
on as Alliance Plus for some reason.
She had told her to pay again.
Well that would have been an oversight then. No.
Okay.
If you're a current paying member and your membership is currently active, you do not have to pay until your current membership expires, in which case we'll ask you to do what you normally do, which is renew. So that would have been an oversight, and in that case you'll get a refund if you already paid up and you paid again. That's definitely not a requirement. Ashok?
Nigo, can you please maybe go over some of the features that we can build a community, to connect with other artists, how we can do that on the website?
If you go to an artist's page, or maybe on Ashok's page, you can see the latest of activity from Ashok. So here, actually, I had submitted a question to one of his images, asking him where this was. Ashok gave me some information about where it was. If you scroll down, if you go look on the left, actually if you scroll down, sorry, you'll see who Ashok's friends are. We're currently logged out, but if you're logged in, you have an opportunity to email Ashok, to add him as a friend, ask
okay.
him to become your friend.
Right.
And of course, if you click on the image, so Mariko, if you can click on one of those images, this is all linked to their profile, so you can see a bigger version, you can see an entire gallery. If you scroll up a little bit, you can look at all images, all albums. This is my albums. Obviously, we're not signed in, but if it was Ashok's page, you would be able to see. He would be able to see all of his images.
So I can connect with other artists directly from my page. What you're saying?
You can absolutely from their page. So
yeah.
You would go to their page,
okay.
You would see their profile, and you, or from their video or from their image.
And
so when you comment on their image, on their video, they will get an email saying Ashok has commented.
Okay.
And
so
then
it looks like Facebook.
The functionality is similar to Facebook in that if you're familiar with setting up a profile with Facebook, it is different. Now we've addressed that question because some people have said, well, how is this different from Facebook? So actually in the help section we have a Q&A, an FAQ, where obviously the functionality is similar to Facebook, but here we have modules that are built specifically for art, for sharing your art, which Facebook is not made for. For portfolios and for your music and for your videos in terms of having an artist page. Of course it's specific to the Asian American arts community of New York City. So again, and we're connected to Facebook, of course. When you see something that you like, so if you like Ashok's image, you can, just like on many other sites, click share on Facebook and it'll go onto your Facebook profile saying, look, I like Ashok's. So this allows members to just get a lot more visibility. The more work you put, the more people are going to see it, the more people are going to comment on it, the more people are going to be sharing your work. And we expect a lot more traffic just because of the way it's a networked system, a lot more traffic coming up, and of course we're going to be monitoring this closely and see how successful it is. But yes, Marika.
So if you want more information in detail as to how Alliance Plus members, which is what you are, Simi, previous paid members are now called Alliance Plus members. There's more information in under the Alliance Plus tab as to how you gain visibility on the site as an Alliance Plus member. Go to Alliance Plus tab.
And then there are other benefits to Alliance Plus that are not on the platform, that we have discounts to some of our events and to some of our workshops, and that we, as you know, we have special events that we get invited to. The mayor's office usually asks us for a list of members when we do, for example, the Chinese Lunar New Year. And so if you ever recently have become a member and got one of those invitations, it was because you were one of you're a member of the Alliance. Christina?
Yeah. Does anybody else can take a look at people's profile, or is only limited to members?
No, so the profiles are public. Now, in order to comment or to add anything, you do have to sign up. So anybody could be looking at your profile, but not anybody, not like you, I suppose YouTube, you also need to have an account, but not everybody can add a comment to your page. You had a question?
Yes, how much is the membership for the Alliance Plus?
Alliance Plus is only $40 for an entire year, and 64 organizations. So, I think if you look around and you look at the other services from other service organizations and what they provide, I think you'll find that it's probably the best bargain in town for what you get. Know that as you have an exhibition and you have images of the artwork or of the exhibition itself, you can put them up, you can update your friends, you can, as you add friends here, you can send messages to your friends saying, look, I've got new photos up of the exhibition that I did yesterday. And so, all right. So, talk to me at the end if you have any questions.
We've been prepared a long time for this, so I understand you want to
know
what you're talking about.
What do you mean? It's only been
half
an hour.
Very friendly.
So I think we'll just go on with the pitches, because I think I'm getting told off here. So we'll continue later. If you all want to ask me questions, then we can discuss. We're gonna continue with the pitches then. Called Elaine Handa, followed by Veronique Lorgo, and followed by Mana Hashim.
Hi, I am Elaine Handa, and I'm the Artistic Director of AH Dance Company. And I have a show coming up next week. I work multidisciplinary. I curated a photography series for the Chameleon Project. There are flyers over there. May 13th to the 15th, I have a photography gallery at Houston Street Center at University Settlement on Houston and Bowery. And then the performances are at University Settlement at 184 Eldridge Street. At the corner of Rivington. I'm one of the artists in residence at University Settlement, and we did work with the Chinese senior community there and did a free performance preview showing in March 30th. Chameleon is a multidisciplinary project about global nomads. I am a second generation global nomad, so basically I grew up all over the world, and so did my parents. Mixture of Singapore, Indonesia, California, New York, London, Boston, Hong Kong, Australia, Indonesia. Did I say that already? Yeah. Okay. So I have flyers over there, and please pick some up. Thank you. Oh, one more thing. The photography is April 30th to May 30th, so you can go and check it out.
Good morning. I'm Veronique. I'm the founder of an organization called Ammonium. I don't know if Mariko can maybe put the logo. It's a kind of platform to promote Indian classical music. The project has been created about 2 years ago and officially launched about 1 year ago. So we're celebrating our first anniversary on May 18, Tuesday, May 18, and we're going to have three amazing musicians from India that will be coming and perform for this first anniversary. We're doing that in a church in West Village, a beautiful space. And so we're here just to have eventually a way to enlarge the audience. We are looking to get more people involved of knowing about the Indian classical music. So if you have any way or any ideas that can eventually help us to enlarge the way to show the beauty of the music, let me know. I'm also looking for a few volunteers for this evening. If anyone can come and help us, that would be beautiful. I have to mention to Teji, that's your name, that I will send you all the musicians. They always have back problems the way they're sitting on the floor playing the instrument. And Sami, I have to say, the first few seconds of your film, I thought it was Indian classical music. it's May 18, Tuesday, May 18. If you never listened to Indian classical music, please come. It's $25, and it's going to be a beautiful, beautiful event. If you want to have more information, our website is harmonium.org, harmonium.org. And we have all information about every concert that's happening in New York. So if you're interested by, you can look at the website, find the information, and just enjoy the music. Huh? And I'm Veronique. Bye. I forgot to give, I was late, I'm sorry, to give flowers, so I will put them there. If you want to come to the event, they will be there. Thanks.
I'm a dancer and choreographer, and also I'm a yoga instructor. And I perform dance based on a buto movement, which is Japanese contemporary dance. And I also workshop around the world, Europe and Japan. This year I was able to get Ella Lehman Cabot Trust grant to teach disability and visually impaired people teach dance for them. And right now I'm working with Vision, which is a visually impaired organization in Manhattan, and BCID, which is in Brooklyn, is an organization to support the independence for disability people. And the teaching dance for them is very important. One is very spiritually uplifting for them, and they need a lot of exercise, because normally they tend to just sit down on a chair, or because of the sight problem, they can't walk around even though they want it. So I work with actually Teiji, he's a physical therapist, so the exercise we create is for their body balance also. And unfortunately, as an artist, but I have to work on this financial part. And those organizations, disability organizations, normally don't have enough money to support this dance program, so I have to be the one who is the doing this financial support to maintain this project. And I'm looking for a lot of financial support right now. So if you know any organization, people I could talk to, please let me know. And also, I'm looking for a yoga studio that I could teach in Manhattan. So if you know some affordable, reasonable studio, easy to get, nice studio, please let me know also. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yan, followed by Semi, take a mark. And then I'm not sure if you're here, but if you are, the folks from Thai Artists Alliance. Okay, so we'll have you next after this.
My name is Chen Chi Yang, I'm original from Taiwan, and I'm the conceptual artist. Actually, when I say conceptual, it means I have an idea and I use all the material or any way I can present my idea, like work more effective. Last year, I did a couple of projects. I try to say my project is like, it's not like do it by yourself, like a DIY. My project is like more like do it with everybody. So that's why every project I have to coordinate with a lot of people. And, I'm kind of like more in the coordination. So I'm maybe not a real artist. So anyway, this time I have a project called Cure Me or Change. Then really talk about is environment. I guess this is like everybody know, very well known. But still, a lot of people know about it, but really action, I think it's very hard for everyone. We already living in modern life for so long. We kind of have a problem to make a little change. Like even we talk about how we're going to save a little water at home. I guess that's very hard. I try every day, but not really success. I tell truth. I try. And the kill me or change is means like I'm going to act like if people don't do it, then how about I die, show you how this is going to happen. So I'm going to correcting like 30,000 cans means like when people born first day until average 80 years old, we kind of like one day per can, like about 29,000 some cans. So I'm going to hang it back on the like a 2 floor high and drop to my head. So something like that. But now I need everybody to help me, like if possible, to correct for 30,000 cans. And also I set up the education program. So anyway, I have a paper here, I have a pen there. So anybody you can help, yeah, great. Thank you very much.
Lotus Music and Dance, and we're a multicultural dance institution, and we're put on Drums Along the Hudson. This is our 8th year. I'm going to show you the video, and whenever you're ready, it's fine. Thank you. the World Cultural Dance Music and Dance Festival. It's a family event. It's open to the public. It's free. It's up in Inwood Hill Park on May 23rd. It's a Sunday. We also have an environmental event, so we do a lot of the environment. So we do a lot of environmental awareness. It's a huge event. You can check out the website for more information. Here's our flyer. What I wanted to do is tell you guys about the event. We have an ad, so if anybody wants to place an ad in our brochure, we have a brochure which goes out to about 5,000 people. We're looking for volunteers. We're looking for you guys to attend. It's a great event. It's free. Bring all your friends. And, you know, it's one of those things that I think Mani was saying, we all don't have enough money, so really it's a free event and we need your support to keep it free and alive in the city. Thank you. I have flyers and ad brochures here if anybody wants to talk to me after.
Hello, my name is Daisy. I'm representing an organization called the Thai Artists Alliance. We're a new organization, just formed last year in October. And basically we're here to sort of encourage and support Thai artists who are living or residing in New York City. It's basically a group of Thai artists who are based here, and basically we decided to do something for ourselves and just form this organization to sort of support each other and find sort of opportunities for us to show our work and expose Thai art and Thai culture. We're about to have our first event coming up this month in late May, May 25th to May 28th. It's going to be a four-day event featuring about 25 Thai artists working across multiple disciplines such as fine art, performing arts, film, photography, and graphic design. So I hope you come, and basically this is our website. It's up now. The event suggested $5 donation to go in, but if you register online and leave your information, you can get in for free. 25 artists will be featured, and we'll be showcasing about 22 pieces, both collaborative and individual as well. The event starts at about 3 to 9 p.m. daily with special events such as multimedia dance performance and film screenings starting from 7 p.m. onwards. So each day will feature something unique in the evening every day that it's on. And like I said, we're a new organization, so everything we're doing right now is first time for everyone. We don't have a lot of experience, so I hope you can sort of help spread the word. And we have brochures and postcards over on the table for you to pick up, and this will include all the details of the program, as well as bios of the artists that will be featured. And our website right now, we're still developing it, but you'll find all the information that's in the brochure and more also on the website as well. And I think that's it. All right, thank you.
If you're here, so please raise your hand. Esther Che? I think so. Ariel Estrada? No. Dina Fei? Is not here. Sumi Kim? Not here. So before we go into the micro pitches, I think this is everybody on this list, I'm going to ask Janice to introduce our gala video and tell us a little bit about a couple of things that are coming up. And then we'll go ahead and get into the micro pitches.
Thanks, Nico. Welcome, everyone, and thanks for sharing your stories. This is what I enjoy most about coming here, to really understand how we can even better support you as artists in this very vibrant city. So what I'd like to show you is the video that was produced by one of our interns. It's Richard Law. Richard, will you please stand up and be acknowledged while I say to two of our interns. Richard has been with us for quite some time. We wanted to produce this video to really help everyone to share the story about the Alliance and the work that we do to in turn support you in finding opportunities and promoting your visibility. So this is what this video is intended to do as we embark on our donor campaign in the spring and our gala, which is in the fall, probably November. So take a look and share the energy and excitement and be part of our family to tell other people about the Alliance and the value that it really brings to all of your professional lives. Take a look.
It's amazing what happens when you bring people together from different sectors, social circles. Asian Americans is a community of many communities. Working together as an Asian American autistic community makes a huge impact on how visible we are and how successful we can be as individuals and as a network. So tonight, we come together as a community to celebrate and appreciate the contributions of five extraordinary Asian Americans in the arts, who we see as leaders in the field. They inspire us, and they remind us that supporting artists is as important as supporting our community leaders in politics, business, science, medicine, and every other sector of society.
That's how I think of the Asian American Arts Alliance, is this place where artists can go and exchange ideas and network and get funding and get their work promoted, and then what they get to give us is this incredible gift that wouldn't be possible without the Alliance.
As you get older and farther away from home, you start to look for family, and for me, when I look out here, it feels like home.
Really, the arts is more than just painting or dancing or theater or music. The arts is giving our community a voice.
I think when you're supporting the Asian American Arts Alliance, a part of supporting the work you're doing right now, you're also supporting that Asian American kid who's at home. He will have role models because of the work that the Asian American Arts Alliance is doing. So write a check before you leave tonight. Bid on an auction item. I don't think anyone's been on lunch with me. It's gonna be really fun.
The other intern who I'd like to acknowledge is not here today, but as you'll see on your chair, this little postcard, this small marketing collateral that was created by Dale Babula, who's a graphic artist. And basically, take a supply of these and tell other people about our town hall, brainstorm workshop, and get people on our new online platform, which we have affectionately named A4 Hub, because that's what you've told us that we are the hub for you, the hub where you come every month to be together with us, and now you can do that 24/7. Who here does not yet have a profile online? A show of hands. Okay, all right, so we have an opportunity. We want to see your profiles in the next 24 hours. How's that? Okay, well, thank you very much. One last notice is that we are still recruiting for a summer intern, part-time intern. If anyone who's interested, please email me or Christy Dam, our development assistant. Thanks for coming.
We already reserved this time for some micro pitches. If you have something that you would like to share, these are 30 seconds. So I usually just keep that in my hand and ring it exactly 30 seconds, but please come up. You want to make sure everybody gets to speak. I think we'll start with Laurent and Vivas, and then after that, folks, please just come up, tell us who you are, and deliver your pitch. Thanks.
My name is Laurent Jacquinot, and I'm going to be part of a show which is opening this Saturday. And it's taking place in a place called BWAC, which is the Brooklyn Waterfront Artists Coalition. It's in Red Hook, Brooklyn. There'll be over 300 artists exhibiting many works in many different kinds of mediums and subject matter. It'll be at, you can get more information at www.bwac.org, or you can ask me after this portion of the, after this part of the town hall finishes.
Hey, my name is, I started on, it takes 90 seconds to come up here. Okay, my name is Vivas Chaudhuri. Recently I was the guest artist in Norway. That was one of my extreme residency, and I have even gone to that far, to the globe. Okay, this is some of the pictures. And nature was so beautiful, at the same time was so dangerous. And so, you know, in a winter I venture out there, and people have such a wonderful sense of humor. And I was a guest artist, which was include free trip to the museum, which does not include any free ride or free groceries. But I was famous, you know, I was in the their newspaper. So then I said, next time when I come, I demand more, not just.
Keishi Chai over there is the artistic director of it, so any specific questions you have can go to Keishi. So Belly Queen's a New York-based belly dance company that just celebrated its 10-year anniversary. We're currently raising funds to take the newest performance to, definitely we want it to be performed in New York and then hopefully nationally and internationally. The performance is inspired by the history of the Silk Road. There's another company, Pure, which is a New York-based dance company that grew out of Belly Queen. Pure does site-specific belly dance performances. There are branches of Pure in cities all over the world. It's a mission-driven company. It reaches out to women with body image issues.
My name is Michael Mao, And I'm actually looking for somebody else, a visual artist who is bilingual either Mandarin or Cantonese and English, and you have to be really fluent, a visual artist who's interested in working with older people. Okay, if you're interested and you think you have those skills, come and talk to me and I'll redirect you. If you can write your name and your email on a piece of paper and give it to me, I'll redirect. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Krista and I'm from the Tribeca Performing Arts Center. Haven't been here in a couple months, so good to be back with you all and see some familiar faces. Just wanted to talk about two things briefly. Our Lost Jazz Shrine series, it's an annual celebration of jazz venues that no longer exist, but were very influential in their heyday. We'll start this Friday, continues through May. I have flyers up there. We are also doing an open call for applications for our next season of our Artist in Residence program. Playwrights, composers, musicians, dancers, any type of performance artist that you are or know of should definitely apply. You do get a stipend and you get to use our theater space for the entire year. And then it culminates in our Working Show Festival production next month, which I'll talk more about next month. All right, thank you. Application, you go over there as well.
Hello everyone, I'm Ashok Sinha. I'm here to talk about two things. First one is some of my images will be part of a group show at the Coalition for Asian Children and Families. That's CACF.org. That's images from my project shot in Xinjiang, China. And that's at Collective Hardware. It's 169 Bowery and Delancey on May 15th. It's a fundraiser, so it starts at 3 p.m. in the afternoon, goes to 9 o'clock. And the second thing I want to remind you is also, I'm organizing a workshop in Ecuador and an artist workshop, and I still have the one spot left. So if you are interested, please come talk to me. Thanks so much.
It's really great to be back. My name is Esther Che. I'm a solo performance artist and writer, and I have a show coming up at Bennett Media Studios next weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So I have flyers here to share with you, and also there is a discount code, Arrow, so please put that in for the $10 discount code. And I believe Governor Patterson will be coming on Friday with other very interesting guest hosts that will be actually hosting each night. So there's more details here. So I just wanted to share that with you. And can we just look at the 2-minute trailer so people have an idea of what it's about?
If you go to there.
It's a solo performance piece about a North Korean spy. The first one. And the Korean American FBI agent that takes her down. Thank you.
That's for a special exemption. She wasn't with this year.
For the U.S. That is the process. That is the price we pay. And now suddenly I'm a legitimate traitor?
United States Code Section 794. Unlawfully delivering national defense information to aid a foreign government.
I'm the fierce warrior, fighting against the savage tyrant, the bloodthirsty dictator that drinks from a sickening cup. I find it vague.
Any more pitches, Michael? Pitches?
I don't know if this is considered cheating if we both talk about the same subject, but I'm a different person. can you please put up bellyqueen.com/video.html? My name is Keishi, and I'm the director of Belly Queen. It's been around in New York since 1998, and we've traveled all over the world. Video, thank you. And I'd like to show you some excerpts from our recent show. journeys along the Silk Road. I introduced belly dance to China in 2006. I was the first US-based dancer to bring it there. I've been part of the first professional belly dance company that tours around the world called Belly Dance Superstars. I danced with them for 2 years. And with Belly Queen, we've toured around America 3 times. And this show has 10 of my dancers, and it involves, check it out, check out bellyqueen.com, and also check out purenyc.org, which is another project that's totally different from that.
I'm conscious of everybody's time, so just in closing, to let you know that Thursday we have a few spots left for our brainstorm workshop in collaboration with New York Foundation for the Arts, Jessica's program, the Knife Editing Program Project, and the Queen's Council on the Arts. Carlo here, who introduced the program today, will be our featured speaker. He'll have 20 minutes to talk about his teaching career, and then we have discussants who sort of chime in and give him feedback, and then we open up to the audience. So it's also very interactive, like town hall, focused on Carlo's work. So please come, let us know. We have a sign up, I think outside, there's about 6 or 7 seats left. I think it's a capacity of 90. So please sign up for that. 2 postcards. We have packs of postcards, 10 postcards. If you are going to events, if people are coming to your events and your members, please take a stack. This is how we do our outreach, is through the, you know, we bring you in here to outreach to other folks, and we need you to spread the word with postcards and also online with the new platform through the invite tab. There's a tab where you can invite people. So please invite the artists in your groups, artists that you know, to come and join with the postcard and online. We're going to be doing information sessions for this new platform at the end of May and into June. So if you have any questions, you want to maximize your visibility on the platform, we're going to be doing one in each borough. We have the dates on the sheet of paper outside, so please check that out. It's going to be end of May till about mid-June. Finally, email list. We'll circulate a list of emails for today to everybody. If you do not want to be on that list, because you do not want to have your email address made available to other folks, let us know, and then we'll remove you from that. Let Mariko know. And finally, the next town hall is here, June 1st, in 4 weeks. Come again, come bring some new food.
Bring a friend.
And you have to have had a postcard in order to enter the building. Now, you have to have set up a profile in order to enter the building. We'll tell the security guard downstairs. So please make sure to do that. Thanks again for coming. Please stay along for a little bit. And we'll see you next month. Thanks a lot.